విద్యా రంగంలోనే అగ్రగామిగా నిలిచిన విద్యా సంస్థ మాంటిసోరీ ఇంగ్లీష్ మీడియం స్కూల్స్ ఫోన్ 227115 మరియు 277022।
Hello and welcome to fourth video. In this video, we are going to learn about specific heat. Before, we learned about heat, but in this, we are going to learn about specific heat. For this, we have to take a beaker. Which is kept on a retort stand. Now, fill the beaker with hot water, which is 80 degrees. Take two test tubes which are inserted into the beaker which is filled with hot water, and two test tubes, one test tube is filled with oil at room temperature. Water one filled with oil at room temperature and the other one filled with water at room temperature, which is 50 grams. Both are having 50 grams each. See the difference between here oil and here water. We all know that heat transfers from hot body to cold body. So here heat is transferred from water to oil and water to water at room temperature. So in this we observe the difference between the transfer of heat energy among the oil and water. Here the main concept is rate of temperature and rate of rise of temperature and nature of the substance. For example, here oil takes 3 minutes to get 40 degrees. Water gets in the 3 minutes 38 degrees centigrade, and another 3 minutes, that is after 3 minutes 6 minutes, here it will come to 45 degrees centigrade. After 6 minutes here it will come to 40 degrees centigrade, here it will come to 40 degrees centigrade, and here it will come to 45 degrees centigrade. In which substance the rate of rise of temperature is more? Here we see that oil is having the rate of rise of temperature is high when compared to the water. So by this conclusion we can say that the specific heat depends on the nature of the substance, because the nature of the oil and the nature of the water are different. As we see here, the temperature, the rising temperature is different for different substances. So that finally we can say that the specific heat depends on the nature of the substance. The specific heat depends on the nature of the substance. And also the rate of rise of temperature is high in oil when compared to the water. This is one activity for specific field, and we will see another activity, simple activity for specific field. Let us consider two beakers, equal volume beakers. Let us consider two beakers which are equal volume. Take 250 grams of water. Here we are going to tell about mass of the substance. We will call really as a liquid like liters like that, but here we have to take it as a mass. So here fill one of the beaker with 250 grams and another beaker with 1 kg water. Here we are taking as mass. Just heat both the beakers with a spirit lamp. With constant temperature until they reach, you have to observe 250 grams of water and 1 kg of water, both are heated with the same flame at same time. Then we have to observe which beaker is reached 60 degrees first. We have to bring them both to 60 degrees centigrade. Which beaker will come first to 60 degrees centigrade? We generally can say that this beaker will come first at 60 degrees centigrade, and this beaker will take much more time to come or reach 60 degrees centigrade. For example, if this takes 5 minutes to reach 60 degrees centigrade, if this beaker takes 5 minutes to reach 60 degrees centigrade, then how much time it takes 1 kg? Simply 20 minutes. It takes 20 minutes. This is 4 parts. So 4 parts 20. 20 minutes it will take. So here we can say that more mass means more heat energy is required. Less mass means less heat energy is required. Simply we are saying more mass means more heat energy is required to get 60 degrees centigrade. Less mass means less heat energy is required to get 60 degrees centigrade. So that here we can denote heat energy with capital Q. As I said before, more mass, more heat energy. Less mass, less heat energy. Both are directly proportional. So that we can say that Q is directly proportional to M, where delta T is constant. Where delta T is constant. Here why we are saying delta T? Delta refers here change in temperature. Here change in temperature from 0 degrees to 60 degrees. But constant, both are constant. This one also 60 degrees centigrade and this is also 60 degrees centigrade. So Q, Q means here heat energy. It is directly proportional to mass. Less mass, less heat energy. More mass, more heat energy. So that we are writing Q is directly proportional to M. And another we will take like this. I take first beaker also 1 kg water. Both beakers are having 1 kg water. But here we are going to give heat energy. Here we know that our stove has to high and sim like that. First one you give here sim. Here high. At a time. Here higher and here sim. We have to reach both to 60 degrees. Both have to reach 60 degrees. Here sim and here high. Which will reach 60 degrees first? We know that here more heat energy is given, so it will reach first, and here less amount of heat energy is given. Here it will reach with lead. Here the rate of rise of temperature is dependent on both. Here the rate of rise of temperature is high because we are giving high heat energy. Here we are having a rate of rise of temperature is less because we are giving less heat energy. Both masses are constant, but we are giving temperatures is different. So less heat energy, less rate of temperature. High heat energy, high rate of rise of temperature. So here also Q is directly proportional to temperature T, where here mass is constant. Here mass is constant. Why? Both are having same mass, but temperature is different. So from these we can write a simple equation for specific heat. Both are directly proportional to each other. So Q is directly proportional to m delta T. Q is directly proportional to mass and Q is directly proportional to change in temperature. So in order to remove proportionality, we have to write a proportionality constant. That is nothing but Q equals to m into s into delta T. This s is the proportionality constant, which is nothing but specific heat. So from this we can calculate specific heat. S equals to Q by m delta T. We can write S equals to Q by m delta T, where S is the specific heat, Q is the heat energy of the substance, m is mass of the body, and delta T is the change in temperature. So we all know that the unit of heat energy is calorie. So we can write specific heat unit. CDS unit of specific heat. We can write by seeing this. CDS unit of specific heat. This is heat energy. Heat energy means calorie, CDS. But calorie per mass. Mass means gram. Delta T, degree centigrade. And SI unit will become, calorie will become joule per kg. Gram will become kg. And degree centigrade will become Kelvin. SI unit of specific heat is joule per kg Kelvin. CGS unit of specific heat is calorie per gram degree centigrade. So finally the definition of specific heat is in this formula only. The definition of specific heat is in this formula. Nothing but the specific heat is the amount of heat energy required to raise the temperature of unit mass of a substance to 1 degree centigrade. Specific heat is the amount of heat energy required to raise 1 gram of substance to 1 degree centigrade is called specific heat. And the applications of specific heat is, applications where we can see specific heat is, oceans are big sources of specific heat. Atmosphere, there are some high hot summer, the temperatures are very very large. These hot summer temperatures can be grasped by the oceans and it sets the constant temperature. And when we take watermelon and keep in a freeze, after some time remove that one and kept on a table, the upper part of the watermelon will be lose coolness and the inner side of the watermelon will be cool. This is due to specific heat of the water. And when we went to bakery like that, there also we have samosa or curry puff like that. In that, when it is taken from the oven, the upper part will be light heat, but inner part will be more heat. This is due to the specific heat of the ingredients. Finally, from this, I am going to ask two questions. That is first one. What is specific heat? The first question is what is specific heat? And the second question is, does the specific heat depends on nature of the substance? Second question, does the specific heat depends on the nature of the substance? Thank you.